I'm Stephen Ohize, and I'll be speaking on what is the true cost of our health desires, expectations versus reality. So, what if I said Nigeria had the best healthcare system in the world? Now, it's easy to take down this statement, because for one, we're rated 187 out of 190 countries by the World Health Organization when it comes to our healthcare systems. We have a second highest maternal mortality rate in the world, next only to India. We have a life expectancy of 55, which is below the global average. What if I said that if we had these numbers 30, 40 years back, we would have been the envy of the world? If we had a life expectancy of 55 in the 60s, that would have made us higher than the global average. The infrastructure we cry about today, if we had them in the 80s, they'll have been premium products, the few you have around the world, making us a health destination for the world. But then why do we feel so bad about our healthcare system? Because we actually feel our expectations, our desires, our expectations are completely driven by the global realities. Around the world today, women rarely die from pregnancy-related issues, so we expect the same in our society. A failed kidney is not a death sentence around the world. You have dialysis machines and transplants. And so we also expect the same thing to happen here. But we don't have it. But I think it is just, it is logical, and it is correct that we must also explain our realities from a global perspective. If our desires are driven completely by the global realities, then what we have, our failures, must also be explained from global realities. So I decided to use countries that drive our expectations. Whatever your ideology is when it comes to healthcare, you should find one of these appealing. The United States, Canada, Japan, and the UK. The bubbles you see here represent their sizes. So you have the US with about 320 million people. You have Japan on this side with 120 million people. Nigeria, 190. And so the sizes represent the population. How much does your government spend on healthcare? I'm looking at this from the cost perspective. You see, for the US, they spend the government, between the central government and the regional government, that is for us, federal and state governments, and the local government, they spend a whooping $1.5 trillion on healthcare per year. Canada spends about $131. Japan, over $400 billion. Nigeria spends $5 billion. And yet, these are the countries that drive our expectations. Now, we know that it's not just government spending that accounts for healthcare. Out-of-pocket spending, most of us pay for our treatments and buy our drugs. So let's add a little layer to these smaller ones, and let's see how high it goes. Let's add the out-of-pocket spending, the NGO spendings, the private insurance, and let's see how high we can take our own bar. Let's leave US out of this addition, because obviously their out-of-pocket spending even doubles their own bar. Let's add it to it. We add another $13 billion to Nigeria, bringing us to about $17 to $18 billion, still on the floor. The rest, you can see. Let's make it simpler. Let's look at how much per person. Let's take out this and let's bring this down. For the US, they spend almost $10,000 per person on healthcare. I'm not talking about just the government, entire spending. Every other person in the range of $4,000. But for us, 97. This is our reality. But yet, our expectations are completely driven by these realities. We just, in 2015, we signed a global pact, the SDG. We want universal health coverage. We want everything the world wants. We make demands of our politicians. Is it bad to make demands? No. Expectations are what drives our innovations. What is expectation when you ignore reality? Wishful thinking. So we have created an expectation-reality mismatch. Is there a problem with that? Why can't we just continue having high expectations and ignore realities? Has that created anything with us? Let's look at the triad of what I think this has created for us as a nation. We have failed policy and leadership. I am a project coordinator for a cancer project in a state in Nigeria that has about 5 million people. One of my projects involved vaccinating young girls against cervical cancer using the HPV vaccine. The cost of vaccinating a person ranges from 20 to 40,000 naira. I'm thinking of vaccinating the entire state. I'm taxed with that. I'm saddled with that responsibility. But nobody cares to ask, what is the budget of the state? Have I not failed from the beginning? And this brought me to thoughts. What about the other people I accused? What about all these other leaders I look at and say they failed? How much is backing our desire? And so we have created policies that have failed economically from the very beginning. This has been our 50-year story. We have created leadership that we have put on them responsibilities beyond what they can achieve. That takes me to the second point. Every government comes with its own reforms. And so we have abandoned what works in pursuit of unrealistic expectations. Every government in Nigeria comes with a reform. Within a single government, you have multiple reforms. And so what happens? While we are growing this way, the rest of the world is here. This is where our expectations are with them. But as we go up, we abandon what works because this is where we want to be, and we come back. We go this way in circles. And when we eventually get here, maybe in 30, 40 years, the world will no longer be here. The day we eventually have dialysis for everybody and kidney transplant, the world will be at 3D printing of organs, which is already far gone. No issues of transplants. We don't have to get a kidney from somebody else before you have your kidney. You don't have to get a heart from somebody else. And the entire problem of rejection is gone. But at that time, our children will also be saddened because their expectations will be where? I want the 3D printing. While we are stuck with what we have. And this is a huge concern, because let's ask our questions. Are we creating the next generation of failed leaders? I hear a lot of talk about youths getting to power, and everything I hear is, if only I can get into power. But I bet you that no matter what you do with $97 per person, you'll be dwarfed by the achievements of this. No matter how much pact you sign, no matter the SDG we sign, if our realities of this is not changed, we'll be stuck. And so come 2030, when we hope to have achieved SDG, the rest of the world will be there. Where would we be? And am I saying this that we should drop our expectations? No. This is what fuels our innovation. So my point here is, what if we had leaders who looked at production? Within the healthcare sector, every CMD, every HOD thinks it is his job just to manage resources. Integrity is a buzzword. If I can manage $97 well, to your best of ability, you will be dwarfed by what these other countries have. And sadly, reality, our expectations come from them. And it's even worse because we are now in a global world where our staff move between countries. Doctors, nurses, health scientists can now write a couple of exams and move between systems. And so every young doctor you have today is thinking about writing PLAB or USMLE to migrate to UK, US, Canada. Most people are filling out the Canadian form to migrate. When it comes to healthcare, there are those societies that are more capitalist-leaning. There are those that are more socialist-leaning. But I dare to say that for us, we practice unrealism. And when we make demands on our leaders, when we listen to their promises, most times we say politicians lie a lot. They make promises they can't fulfill. What about you? Why would you believe promises that can't be achieved? And so as we listen to our leaders, as we desire to take positions of authority within the healthcare sector, and I could do this chart for every single sector. I think I can do this chart I've tried this chart for every single third world country, both in Africa, and the same picture is what you get. Everybody is driven only by their expectations, nothing about reality. And so my hope today is to make you ask the question, as you think about what you want to be in future, as you hold leaders responsible, as you make demands on our leaders, hope we always ask the question, what is the true cost of our health desires? Thank you.